pain medication must be kicking in.
It is time to get to the moment I've been dreading in this entire Led Zeppelin series, the presence review. And there it is right there.
We're not reviewing rumors.
Welcome back. If Presence is your favorite Led Zeppelin album, I'm very sorry. It's not one of my favorites. But I mean, no, we will have some people that will like this album. Some people that won't. I'm expecting this to be a very polarizing album, to say the least. So, let's go ahead and without further ado, go ahead and get into the album. I will say this particular album does have some very interesting history behind it. So, Briar, if you want to go ahead and take it away with our background information.
Background information!
Okay. So, yeah, quite a bit happened between Physical Graffiti and this album, and wasn't that much of a time's gap because this album came out in March 31st, 1976. And, you know, at this point, again, they were still on top of the world. They were still touring nonstop. Again, Physical Graffiti did tremendously well. But things went south when Robert Plant got into a car accident. And yeah, it was pretty bad. He didn't die, of course, but definitely left him seriously injured. And so by the time it was time to record the album, he had to sing all his vocals in a wheelchair. So they decided to record this in Munich for a change of scenery. And I've read that Robert Plant really was not having fun while recording the album. Not only is he in a wheelchair, but of course he found the whole environment kind of claustrophobic. They were kind of recording in this very tiny studio. And also because he was homesick, he was kind of missing home. He had a family by this point. So he kind of wanted to go home to that. And surprisingly enough, this was the shortest amount of time for them to record an album. Which is kind of interesting. And the reason didn't take them as long was because in the exact same studio, the Rolling Stones were going to record their album, Black and Blue. So they had to kind of rush it almost. And I think Jimmy Page even had to beg the Rolling Stones to give him like an extra 2 days to at least finish mixing. So that was a thing. But that was pretty much all the
amazing albums in the same studio.
Yeah, I know, right? So they got it done, and they released it, and sold still pretty well. Of course, the reviews not as strong as the last album, and I've also read this is actually their lowest selling album, and it doesn't shock me because of that. But commercially still did pretty decently. It went to number one in the UK and the US. So it still commercially did really well. But again, it got a lot more mixed reviews than before. And yeah, this is often, I guess that's pretty much all the main information of the album. But I guess I'll quickly go into like my quick thoughts on the album. But I do hear that at least at this point, the band was beginning to run out of steam. This is kind of a more stripped back sort of album. It's not quite as experimental as the previous ones. It's kind of like more, it's almost like it's harkening back to like the early period with the more heavy, more emphasis on blues rock. But for me, I'm kind of, I'm, yeah, I'll just come out and say it. Like, I don't hate this album. I don't think it's terrible, but it's definitely a step down, a huge step down from the last album. But that's pretty much my two cents on it. I'll go more in depth as we go along.
Right, were any songs a radio hit? Maybe Nobody's Fault But Mine might have been a hit, but
I know they released singles, but obviously they're not really as well remembered these days.
Well, without further ado, we are going to go ahead and get to our first track, and that is Achilles' Last Stand.
All right, so I can't see anybody's face when I do this. I just have to imagine what you guys are looking like, I guess. All right. Yeah, we start with Achilles' Last Stand, kind of the big epic song to start the album. It's the longest song, I believe. It's like 10.5 minutes. And my first feeling was like Bonham really was earning his paycheck on this song.
Right, yeah.
I'm going to make my money on this song. like I'm going to give you the freakingest best drum playing you ever hear in your life. I feel like someone said, I think Keith Moon is the best drummer. And Bonham said, hold my whiskey. And he just blew the doors off of everybody. Like, I always say Keith Moon's my favorite drummer. But after hearing this song, like, it's hard not to say Bonham, maybe the greatest rock drummer of all time. I think this is I have a hard time thinking of anything that's better than this as far as drumming. The drumming, just killing it. And the guitar playing is amazing. It's, like I said, so long. There's so many guitar solos in here, and they're all amazing. It's just like one great guitar solo after another. And it's just a cool rocking song. I love it when, my favorite part is when, he's playing, I think, and Bonham's doing, it's like, da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da. Mm-hmm. It's like this super fast-paced fills, which I'm like, holy cow, he's playing so fast, and he's hitting it so hard. And yeah, I was like, I love this song. It took me a while to actually get into it. I actually had to listen to it, at least 3 times before I was like, you know what, this song's like really awesome because of the guitar playing and the drumming is just some of the best I've ever heard out of Led Zeppelin. So yeah, it's, to me, this is what a way to start this album. On a really hot, really, really good note.
Okay, Achilles' Last Stand. Yeah, this is one of two songs I really like on this album. Pretty much like what Jason said, the drumming on this track is amazing. John Bonham really gets his chance to shine and prove that he's one of the best drummers in music, and he really proves it in this song, especially like that. Very heavy track, some good guitar work from Jimmy Page. It's one of two songs where Robert Plant really sings out, and he does a good job here, going into like the folklore and mythology. Achilles, I think we're diving into Greek mythology in this song. Really cool stuff. Even though it's 10 minutes, it moves by at a good pace, and I think this is easily one of the more memorable songs on the album. Again, it's one of two songs that I like on an otherwise crappy album.
Okay. Achilles' Last Stand. Wow. What a way to open up your album. You get that fade in with that guitar riff. Boom, down, 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 boom. And it just goes, boom. And then bottom. Down, boom. There's like a John Bonham is doing like this crazy thing on the drums, and John Paul Jones is holding it all together with this galloping bass line. And then Jacob was talking about how it's 10 minutes, but a lot like Stairway to Heaven, it's one of those ones where it's like, it's a long song, but you can't really tell how long it is because it's so amazing. Oddly enough, this song, while being the longest song on the album, there is at least two other songs on this album I feel longer than this song. Robert Plant, even though he's in a wheelchair, this song is one of the songs that he actually gives a pretty good vocal performance on, retelling the tale of Achilles going off to war And I love the guitars. There's lots of guitars on here. This was Jimmy Page's Guitar Army in Play. I love the part that goes... that's one of my two favorite parts of the song. That and the my other favorite part of the song is when it goes... That part's epic. Epic is just a very good way to describe this song. It is one of my two favorite songs on the album, this and another song, and honestly, I feel like it's sadly a very poor representation of the rest of what this album sounds like, though.
Yeah, I don't really have much else to add. I think everybody has talked great depth on why the song is great, and yeah, I'm not gonna front. This is by far the best song on the album. It's not like it's just Achilles Last Stand is here, and then everything else is kind of somewhere below that. It's like a big margin between this. But yeah, I mean, like everyone said, Bonham's drumming carries this song, is by far the big standout on this song. But of course, you have Robert Plant giving one of the better vocal performances on here. That's something I'm going to say. This is definitely the album where I think his vocals are very hit or miss. But this is definitely one of the better ones. And yeah, I mean, John Paul Jones, like, even though he's not doing as much, like, different not playing on different instruments, it's still very good. I mean, like, it's great, great bass line. But yeah, and also the guitar work is very good too. But yeah, otherwise, yeah, this is a terrific song. Great opening song.
This is an amazing song. Kind of like with Briar, everyone kind of gave their two cents in already, and I kind of agree with everyone. The drumming is great. I think that's definitely the best part about the song. This is probably not my favorite song on the album, but it's definitely in my top three at least. It's epic.
Track two, For Your Life.
Yeah, I thought this song was actually a pretty good rock song overall. I actually quite enjoyed it. I think it hits you right away with that guitar riff, and I really like that. I love when they hit you right away with the guitar riff and get you right into that song, get you rocking. So I thought they did a real good job hitting you with that. And overall, I thought the guitar, drums, bass was all really excellent. Again, Bonham is not losing anything from the first song. He's still like, I'm still proving myself as the greatest drummer maybe of all time. It's a good argument right now after hearing these first two songs. It's like, yeah, he's just killing it on this album, on these two anyway. So yeah, I thought this was actually a pretty good one. One of the better ones.
All right. This song is terrible. Contender, well, I would say it's the second worst song on this album. There is some good guitar playing on this song. And yes, the drumming in it is great, but this song is just a muddled mess. Robert Plant, I have no idea what he was doing vocally on this song. It's a mix between croaking out his vocals or phoning it in. I don't know what he's doing. It's all over the place. Like, it's like, is it a song about love or is it a song about drugs? I don't know. Make up your mind.
Probably both.
But yeah, what's crazy is you have Achilles Last Stand, which is 10 minutes long. This song is about half that, and this song feels 10 minutes longer than Achilles Last Stand. I did not enjoy this one. It's garbage.
Okay. I'm not exactly going to pull out the garbage can on this one, but it's one of those songs that I like the riff better than the song behind it. I love the boom, boom. John Bonham's drums behind that. I love that groove. But then, like, whenever Robert Plant comes in, it's like, that's really what you're going to go with behind that groove? It's just... Oh, you can tell he's in a wheelchair. He's not at his full potential on here. It's very long, very long. I don't think the song needed to be as long as it did. Achilles Last Stand definitely merited its long length. This is too long for what it is. Perhaps this album would have done better, and I hate to say this, perhaps most of this album would have done better as an instrumental album. I'm not a big fan of Robert Plant's contributions to most of this album.
Yeah, so for me, I thought this was okay. I don't think it's terrible or anything. You know, the bass and drums, I think they're pretty locked in pretty well. And the guitar work is pretty good too. But I am going to agree with what most people have said. This is definitely one of Robert's more hit or miss performances. Like, it's not terrible, but it just you can tell something's off. Like, you can tell he's probably not giving it his all this time around. But you know, it has a decent groove to it, but for me, I feel like the groove, like the initial groove, kind of at first you're like, okay, I'm digging the groove, but then at some point you kind of get to the point where you're like, okay, anything else? Is there anything else besides this? And then when it does switch up, it does pick up a little bit, but by the time it does come in, it's kind of a bit too late. You're kind of already kind of zoning out. But, you know, it's one of those songs I feel is like, in the moment, it's like you're digging it. But then once the song's over, you're kind of already moved on. But overall, it's decent. It's not bad.
Well, Jason, I'm with you on this. I actually really like the song.
All right.
I'm probably the one who likes the song the most, actually. I love Robert Plant's vocals. I think it's really good. Really, really good, actually. Especially at the end when he's like, "For your life." I personally find no issues with his vocals. The guitar playing, I agree, is definitely the best thing about the song. And I agree with Jason. I think John Bonham's drumming's amazing, and I even think the bass playing's amazing. I find this to be an amazing song. I'm gonna have to disagree with you strongly, Jacob. I really enjoy the song.
Royal Orleans.
All right. This song I thought was okay. Not as good as the last two songs. I think were much better. But I feel like I'm going to say the same thing on each song on this album. That is, the instruments are just absolutely killing it on pretty much on all the songs, except for maybe one. But for the most part, I'm loving what the drums are doing, what the guitar is doing, what the bass is doing. I kind of agree. Robert Plant's maybe the weakest part of this album. I don't think he's giving it his best vocal work or his most memorable, like, unique vocals that he's so good at. But it doesn't totally ruin the song. It's just not as good, maybe. But it's just, to me, it's like, it's in the middle. It's an okay song.
Yeah, I'd say I'm in agreement with Jason on this one. This one's not as bad as some of the other tracks on this album. This one's just okay at best. There's good production on this song, especially the guitar riff's pretty good. I will say off the bat, the saving grace on this album is John Bonham. The drumming on this album is absolutely incredible. So shout out to John Bonham for at least playing it his all on this album, if anything else. But again, Robert Plant, he just sounds so like he's phoning it in on most of this album, and it's no exception on this song. And I think what would be a really rocking song on other albums when he's in full health, here when he's recovering from an accident, singing in a wheelchair, he's just not giving it at all. And I think I'm being harsh on that, but you know, Freddie Mercury was dying of AIDS when Queen did the Innuendo album, and he was on the verge of death, and they did The Show Must Go On in one take, and Freddie Mercury sang it like a pro. So it can be done. It's just Robert Plant as no Freddie Mercury.
Yeah, I kind of agree with that. We're not hating on Robert Plant. We're just not up to his usual standards. Like, if you've heard, like, Since I've Been Loving You, one of his best vocal performances. If you've heard Stairway to Heaven, or like something, Rain Song, Cashmere, Communication Breakdown, like. Listen to pretty much any other album, and he's going to be singing a whole lot better than that. The Immigrant Song, man, it's just a letdown. I know it was the wheelchair, but like, come on. I like this song better than For Your Life, just because I think the riff is catchier. I like that better than but that's about all I like about this song is the riff. It gets old after a few minutes, and then you're like, okay, I just want to flip the record over and get to Nobody's Fault But Mine already.
Okay, so I'm kind of kind of a similar bow. Yeah, this is another. This is pretty run of the mill for me. I mean, I'm looking at my song ranking, and it's literally in the middle. But yeah, I think it's a pretty decent song. Again, people talk about the guitars. The guitar is pretty nice, and I also like the bass playing. I did notice that. I did pay attention to the bass on this one. I think it's pretty good from Jones. But yeah, again, some of us have already mentioned it. But yeah, Robert Plant's vocals. This is another one of them where it definitely feels off. Still not quite the. Not one of his better ones, but again, it doesn't like ruin the song. Like he sounds okay, but it sounds good enough to get by. But you know, again, it just we've heard better vocals from him, and yeah, this is kind of below that. But yeah, it's still I didn't have much else to say about it, but it's a fine song.
I really like this song. It's another really good song for me. I like the riff a lot. I think. Robert Plant really sings good on this song, too. I'm just going to say it. I think, besides one particular track, I think Robert Plant sings amazing throughout this album. The guitar riff definitely gets stuck in my head. I think this is a fantastic way to close out the first side of the album.
Nobody's Fault But Mine.
This will probably be the second one we're all going to agree is, like, really good on this album. Definitely, to me, this is one I feel like I've heard before. Like, it maybe was on the radio. Because I definitely remember that opener. The opener is so iconic to me. Like, when I heard it, I was like, oh, yeah, I've heard this somewhere. I can't remember where, but I was like, I know I've heard this before. But it's probably the best opener on... I mean, yeah, I would say it's the best opener on the whole album. I mean, it's a really great opener. I can't do it. And then, yeah, when the drums and the bass kick in, it's like, oh, man, that's amazing. Like, I love that, how they open that. The guitar sounds so cool. Like, I don't know what they did with the guitar, but it has such a cool sound to it, tone to it that they do, that it's just awesome. Like, I love the sound of the guitar on this song. Yeah, and there's more of that, kind of that, like, oh, throughout the song that you're like, oh, my gosh, like that's such an awesome riff. And I think this is Robert Plant's best vocal work on the whole album. The one song where I'm like, okay, this sounds like Robert Plant of the other albums. Like, this is him kind of giving that very unique vocal that only Robert Plant can do. Like, the way he sings, like, nobody else can sing like he does. And it's so unique to the band. And it's really kind of, I mean, not the only thing, but one of the things that really, I think, makes this band stand out is his vocal work. But I love that when it's like, nobody fault but mine. And like I love that transition from him kind of singing a cappella to all the instruments coming back in, and there's some great guitar solos in this. Like, and again, if Kaylee's Last Stand I think is maybe the best drumming I've ever heard in my life, this song is maybe the second best drumming I've ever heard in my life, because Bonham is still like proven like he's the greatest drummer of all time on this song. It's just, I was like, man, like I'm just blown away by what Bonham is doing here. Besides, everybody else is killing it, but definitely Bonham is like the MVP for me on this album.
Mm-hmm.
But great song.
As you know, I'm not the biggest fan of this album, but I really love this song. Woohoo! Yeah, the guitar work on this song is amazing. And the percussion. John Bonham that Jason already talked about, amazing. That Robert Plant's best vocals is in this song. This is Achilles' Last Stand, the only two songs where Robert Plant doesn't phone it in, and he does an amazing job. And it's a nobody's fault but mine, nobody's fault but mine. Botches and breaks his voice, but whatever. There's just some cool production on this. This is easily a hidden gem, I think, in Led Zeppelin's discography. I think this is the one they should have pushed as a single instead of Candy Store Rock, but we'll talk about that when we get there. I love the pauses in between sections. So you have the and then it pauses for like a couple seconds. Whenever Robert Plant starts singing again, I'm like, man, this song rocks. This might be an unpopular opinion, but I'm gonna say it. This is my favorite song.
Who screamed?
Nobody's fault but mine. The song's amazing. I love the guitar at the beginning. It's the guitar effect that Jason really likes is called flanging. That's the guitar effect. It's kind of the same effect that's used on like Barracuda, but it's a little bit more turned up on the guitar on this. You got the guitar and Robert Plant singing with the guitar. And then John Bonham comes in with this drumming. Robert Plant singing is actually good on this song, and like a lot of the other songs on this album. And man, Robert Plant is rocking that harmonica in the middle. My goodness, it's amazing.
Yep, I'm going to agree. Yeah, this is another pretty good song on here. Definitely another big standout. And again, everyone's already pointed out what I was going to say, but again, this is definitely another one of Robert's. Definitely one of his best performances on this album. Definitely sounds more in line. And yeah, the musicianship on here is top notch. Great guitar. I really dig the guitar intro. Really great way to open it up. And again, the drum groove on here is very good. Really strong stuff. And again, I think Jones is playing on bass. His bass playing on here is also very good. Again, just there's Bonham and Jones. Scott already mentioned it, but the harmonica solo is probably my favorite part on the song. Just it's very cool that they brought harmonica out, and that's kind of like my thing. Every time Robert Plant brings out the harmonica, it's always like a nice little highlight. I'm gonna agree, it's my second favorite, but there you go.
I love this song. So far Led Zeppelin's 4 for 4 with their songs for me. I'm going to go right out and say it. I'm agreeing with Jacob. This is my favorite song on the album as well. This is awesome. I love the groove of it. I love the beginning. This is an epic song. If there's a song that should have been the single on the album, it definitely should have been this.
The big single, Candy Store Rock.
Yeah, I think this is Breyer's favorite song, Candy Store Rock.
I love candy.
I might be wrong on that. Oh, I must have heard wrong. Yeah, so the first 4 songs, I'm like, it's funny, I come to this album, and I remember thinking this was the worst album of Led Zeppelin, and I was like, oh man, this is not going to be good, because I thought there's really not much memorable songs on here, and then I'm listening to the first 4, and I'm like, this is actually a pretty good album, like, I'm like, really on board, like, there's 2 amazing songs here, the other stuff's not bad, and then I get to this song, and I'm like, oh, this is when it goes downhill, or like, over halfway through the album, it's like, okay, this is when it gets not good for me. My feeling was, it felt like he was trying to do Elvis, and it just didn't work for me. I was like, listen, go, gosh, I just do not care for this style of music that they're going for, and it's way different than everything else they've been doing. And I remember, you know, we talked about, like, the crunch. They're, like, he's trying to do, like, a James Brown impression or something. And I guess for me, I felt like he's trying to do an Elvis impression, and I don't know why. It just didn't work for me.
This song sucks.
Still a piece of garbage.
It's not Candy Store Rock, it's Candy Store Sucks. main problem with this song, what's sad is you could have done a cool rockabilly-inspired song. Kind of like Elvis, what Jason was talking about. But yeah, Robert Plant trying to sing like Elvis does not work. It comes off as lame and cringe. I mean, the lyrics of this song are just absolutely embarrassing. It's like, oh, baby, baby, something sweet, or something like that. Oh, boy. And then just, this to me, this song is just a lamer version of what Zeppelin previously did with rock and roll. And even, Trample Underfoot, where it was trying to do, like, I think sexually charged lyrics with a killer production. And this is like a worse version of that. And the percussion's very similar. I think Scott pointed this out. It's kind of like 4/6, but we poke fun of 4/6 for being the weakest song on 4, but at least 4/6 is good because of the percussion. This just feels like a worse version of better Led Zeppelin songs. And because of that, garbage can.
Yeah, this is just rockabilly 4/6, if we're going to be honest. Like, I think 4/6 is a lot better than this. Cause
yeah.
It's like, what the heck? Well, I need to bring it out here. Where's my garbage can?
The white garbage can, the black garbage can.
I hate this song. This is one of my least favorite Led Zeppelin songs. Like, it's so cringy. The sound of it is just like, meow, 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 meow. I mean, John Bonham's drumming is all right on there, but in true 1950s style, they mixed him down for the other instruments. So you can't hear Bonham as well on this track. Yeah, Jacob was talking about the lyrics. This is the cringiest lyrics that Led Zeppelin has ever done. Like, what is it, like, oh, baby, baby, you look good enough to eat? Like, what the heck? Comparing your girl to candy? It's like... Like, at least the Cars was kind of funny on Trampled Underfoot. This is just... weird, like it doesn't even make any sense. Every time I hear this song, it just makes me cringe. So I'm gonna play the garbage for me.
Still a piece of garbage. Still a
trash. Yeah.
This song is really stupid. I kind of liked it.
Oh no.
I know. Yeah, it's so stupid, but it's so, I find it hilariously bad that I kind of liked it for it. Because, yeah, the lyrics are dumb as heck. And I love candy, but, you know, but that doesn't change the lyrics so much. But, yeah, it's kind of like this weird rockabilly sort of thing that they're trying to do. And Robert's trying to emulate it, even though he's failing miserably at it. And the music itself, it's actually quite decent. I mean, Bonham's drumming is still pretty good, and the bass playing, again, that was the big highlight for me. And apparently I've read that this is actually one of Robert Plant's favorite songs on the album. He actually really enjoyed this song. He said okay, that Achilles Last Stand and Candy Store Rock were the saving grace on this album.
I have a message for Robert Plant.
All right.
You lose! Good day, sir!
Yeah. Well, Walker said it.
But yeah, it's one of those songs that's so bad. I actually think it's kind of humorous. I think it's entertaining. At least it's memorable. But there you go. That's my two cents on this.
Even though it's so bad, it's one of those songs. It's good. Kind of like Briar. I like the song.
That is good.
Is it single worthy? Hell no.
Yeah, no.
It's not single worthy at all. But yeah, I still like it though. I like the groove of it.
Yeah, well, you know, that's just like your opinion, man.
Hots on for nowhere.
I love that we have Willy Wonka criticizing a song that's called Candy Store Rock. Like, that's like, if anybody knows anything about candy stores, it's Willy Wonka. But anyways, Hots on for nowhere. Again, I thought the song was like okay. I think it's sandwiched between the two worst songs on the album. Like, this last half of the album is definitely like the worst part of the album. That really, like I said, the first four songs, I'm like, hey, this is not bad. And then we get to the last three, I'm like, oh, this is not good. So unfortunately it kind of hurts it. But again, I think this is not a terrible song. I think the drums are still really good here. And I think it's actually some of the best bass work I've heard on the album. Like, I just remember there's like one section at least where I really heard the bass and I was like, oh, that was a really good bass part. Like, and I'm sure he's killing it on every song. I just get overwhelmed with the drumming. I always think, I forget, oh yeah, there's other people on this album too, besides the drumming. But anyways, yeah, again, towards the bottom of my list, but definitely not the worst.
Still a piece of garbage.
Sad thing is, the rhythm of this song is actually pretty cool. I actually really like John Paul Jones' bass work on this song. But what the heck was up with the... That got annoying after a while. It feels surface level compared to what I've come to expect from Led Zeppelin, and this feels like you can feel the crunch on this album. What do we gotta write on this random song? Okay, let's just put na 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 na. It's like, okay.
Yeah.
Still a piece of garbage.
Yep, this song is awful. So, yeah, the bass playing and the drums are good. Even though they're good, it's still kind of annoying. That kind of gets annoying with the la 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 la. That gets super annoying really fast. I hate that. That grates on my nerves. This song is just bad. Like, I can't even say much more about this song. It's just bad.
Hey, yeah, this is, we're kind of going back to more mediocre territory. Again, instrumentally, it's fine. It's fine. It's got a good groove. And I want to like it more, but again, it goes back to Robert Plant. Again, this is another one of his hit or miss performances. And yeah, the chorus. Yeah, not one of their finest moments. Kind of lazy. You're just hoping something good is gonna come up, but it never happens. I don't have much else to add. Hats on for Nowhere. Yep, there's nowhere I want to listen to.
I love this song. Like, the last song is one of those, like, it's so bad it's good. I actually really like the song. In between everybody giving their opinions, I'm actually listening to these songs as we're going along. I'm loving it. I actually, like, by the time the song ended, I actually played it. That's how much I liked it. This is a really good song. I like the chorus. I actually like the chorus. Don't shoot me. I'm only a Ranger fan.
This is your honey don't moment.
Yeah, exactly. This is my Mr. Moonlight moment. Moonlight. I love this song. This isn't like, oh, it's good. I like it. I like it better than everyone. No, I freaking love this song.
Okay, I won't shoot you, but I will have to quote a dude named the Dude.
Yeah, well, you know, that's just like your opinion, man.
T for one.
All right, I think we can say it all together on this one.
Still a piece of garbage.
It's too long. It's too bluesy.
It's too bluesy.
This is the second longest, I think, on the album. It's 9.5 minutes. And oh my gosh, it felt like 9.5 minutes. And it's so boring. It was just such a boring, slow-moving song. And it was so much different than everything else on this album, because even Candy Store Rock had a fast pace to it, I think. Every song was somewhat rocking, fast pace. The drums and the guitar was just killing it. And then this one, it's like, wow, they just slowed it down and made it so bluesy. It's my least favorite style of Led Zeppelin. It's what I complain about in every Led Zeppelin album when you get to one of these songs. And it finishes the album, which is such a bad finisher to this album, where you have to get to this one and go, oh man, you have to get through 9.5 minutes of this to finish up the album. And it's unfortunate. It leaves the album on a kind of bad taste in a sense. But yeah, this is terrible.
Well, you thought nobody's fault but mine was the best song on the album? Well, I trolled you all. It's gone. Okay. It's garbage. Wow. I just can't even fathom like how bad this song actually is. This is easily the worst song on the album. The sad thing is, there's a really good intro. They're rocking out. And I'm like, oh, man, are we going to have another When the Levee Breaks? This is going to be really epic. Then I'm starting to hear the slow down production. I'm like, I've heard this style of music before. Where have I heard this? This song is essentially Since I've Been Loving You 2.0, but suckier and a heck of a lot more boring. what were you doing on this song? You were sleepwalking through this entire song. He was like, oh, 24 hours.
The pain medication must be kicking in.
This song is 9 minutes. Achilles' Last Stand feels shorter than like half of the songs on this album. Even when you Candy Store Rock and the Hats Off one, whatever, like, they feel longer than Achilles' Last Stand. This song feels like an eternity. This song, oh my god. This and Roy Harper are the two worst songs of Led Zeppelin's career.
I've been thinking about it, and yeah, this is the worst song on the album. This is awful. They trick you out with that amazing intro. It's only like a 15 seconds or something, and then it starts up, and I'm like, oh no. It's Since I've Been Loving You Again, but like less interesting. And it just drags on for so long. Okay, I'm not going to have to actually agree with Jason for once. This is too long and too bluesy. Like, Jimmy Page's guitar is not on fire on this song. It puts me to sleep. And I am so ready to get to In Through the Outdoor. It is a much better album than this. I know people are like, oh, I don't like In Through the Outdoor. It's not as Led Zeppelin's doing pop music and they lost all the heart. But yeah, I hate this album. I hate this song. I'm ready to get to the next one so we can talk about some good Led Zeppelin again. This is.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, hearing, being reminded of Tear for One put me to sleep. But yes, yeah, I got nothing to add here. Yeah, I did not care for the song at all. It was so boring. And again, I don't mind blues, but at least, I mean, it's all in my time of dying. It's long, but at least it went somewhere. This went nowhere. Just played the same slow tempo beat, and we already mentioned how it teases you in the beginning, like you think you're gonna get something awesome, but no, you're just stuck in this slow monotone. And Robert, again, another one of Robert Plant's more hitter, like not one of his best moments. Like, even he sounds bored. And even when Bonham, like, every so often his drumming, he'll get more intense, but again, it's just, it doesn't really change anything. He still goes back to that same drawn out beat. But yeah, it was very bad way to go out here. Yeah, this was a drag.
I really like this song.
Oh no. Okay.
I don't get the hate for it. It's just, I will agree, Since I've Been Loving You is a million times better, like way better, like no comparison. Like if you're comparing those two songs, it's like one's way up here and then like one's like way down there. But I still really like this. I think the guitar work in the 5 minute mark is awesome. I think the guitar is really what really makes the song really good for me. Yeah, me personally, I really, really like the song. I have no problem with it, to be honest. This is a really good song. Definitely my least favorite song off the album, but yeah, this is I really enjoy it.
All right, so yeah, 7's T for One, 6 is Candy Store Rock, 5 is Hot Zone for Nowhere, 4 is Royal Orleans, 3 For Your Life. And so top two, man, this was so hard. These are two really good songs. Like, they're neck and neck for me as the two best songs on this album. But I am going to go with Achilles' Last Stand at number 2 and Nobody's But Mine at number 1.
Nice.
All right, for me, easily in last place, T for One. Number 6, For Your Life. Number 5, Candy Store Rock. 4, Hats On for Nowhere. You know this album is bad when the Na 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 song is number 4. 3, Royal Orleans. Number 2, Achilles' Last Stand. And number 1, Nobody's Fault But Mine.
Awesome.
Number 7, Kiefer won. Number 6, Hot Song for Nowhere. Number 5, Candy Store Rock. Number 4, For Your Life. Number 3, Royal Orleans. And then a huge jump in quality to number 2, Nobody's Fault But Mine. And number 1, Achilles' Last Stand.
Okay. In my comfy fashion, here's my ranking. Number 7, yep, T for 1. Number 6, Hots On for Nowhere. Number 5, Candy Store Rock. Number 4, For Your Life. Number 3, Royal Orleans. And yep, same top 2 like everyone else. I have number 2, I have Nobody's Fault But Mine. And number 1, Achilles' Last Stand.
Before I give my ranking, I just gotta let you know this is 100% my opinion.
Scott's calling. You know what? No, I'm not gonna play the dude. I should play the dude for me once, because like, you know what? It's your opinion and you can stick by it.
Wait a minute, you love T for 1?
7's T for 1. I like T for 1, yeah. That's
a good all agree one. On that.
I could at least agree that's on the bottom one though.
Okay.
Number 6, it's gonna be Royal Orleans. Number 5, Candy Store Rock. This is going to be the one that gets everyone. Number 4, Achilles' Last Stand.
It's a trap!
Number three, Hot Song for Nowhere.
Wow.
I love that song. I don't care. Just my opinion. Number 2, that's For Your Life. My favorite song on the album, Nobody's Fault But Mine.
Yeah, all right. So the panel split on the number 1. That's kind of interesting.
Yeah.
That's kind of cool. Yeah, it's funny. Breyer said, coming from Physical Graffiti to Presence, he said this was a big step down. I disagree. I thought this was a step up. And
what?
I think the reason why it was a step up because it was a shorter album. if Physical Graffiti could have cut out like 7 songs, that would be a much better album. But in fact, looking at all the albums, none of them are very long. They're like, I think House of the Holy is like 8 songs, 4 is like 10 or something, 2 is like 9. So none of them are very long, but this is like the shortest at 7, I think. And the next album's going to be 7 songs. So they definitely weren't really prolific with their songs on these albums. Interesting. But coming back to this album, I 2 just amazing songs. 3, that third song I thought was actually quite good. 2 I thought were okay. 2 I thought were terrible. So So in the end, I came out with a 7 out of 10.
Wow. Not expecting a 7.
should I play the dude?
Yeah.
Well, I could have. Yeah, there's no opinion, man.
Your opinion, man.
Okay. I'm not going as high as a 7. That's the same rating I gave Physical Graffiti. And yeah, there's some filler on that, but that still has some good stuff on that album, Physical, the Cashmere and My Time of Dying. Yeah, this is easily their worst album. I think it's a huge step down. I only like 2 songs on this album, 2 out of 7 songs. One is just okay, and the rest are terrible. So when you got a majority of songs that are terrible, it's a bad album. And yeah, just the fact that the album was rushed, Robert Plant was still recovering from an accident and he wasn't really into it, and you could tell he was phoning it in. This is not a good album. 2 out of 10.
Here's the thing about Presence is at face value, it's not a horrible album. It's just, let's look at what they've done in the past, shall we? Led Zeppelin 1, Led Zeppelin 2, Led Zeppelin 3. Think of all the amazing songs on those albums. Think of the amazing songs on Led Zeppelin 4. All the amazing songs on Houses of the Holy. All the amazing songs on Physical Graffiti. And then they released this. It's almost like,
look how they messed with my boy.
Led Zeppelin got, something happened. And I know it's Robert Plant being in the wheelchair that had to do a lot with it and rush schedules and whatever, but like, they're capable of so much better than this. I'm giving it a 6.5. I was going to give it a 7, but then like,
not far.
How boring T for 1 is, and
yeah,
all these things with this album. Yeah, not good. The only reason it ranks at that high is because of Achilles Last Stand and Nobody's Fault But Mine. But yeah, no, it's not a very great album in my opinion, and I'm very excited to get to reviewing the next one, which in my opinion is a lot better.
You know what? I'm gonna give it a 7. You can definitely tell they're. I do agree they were kind of starting to run out of steam a bit. Again, there was other things that was going on, which you know, kind of played a role in the production. But you know, again, there are two songs that are definitely, like we all agree, there's definitely two big gems here, and then everything else kind of has ranges from being decent to not good at all. But you know, I think the songs that I liked kind of saved it from being any lower. I still think the playing itself is pretty solid for the most part. Again, Bonham still kills it. Even if this is one of the weakest albums, still his drumming definitely is the saving grace here. And even John Paul Jones's bass playing, I still think it's pretty top. It's pretty good too. But yeah, it just comes down to the facts. Again, Robert's vocals just aren't strong, and even the actual songwriting is not that strong either. But again, it's okay. It's also my least favorite Led Zeppelin album still. But again, it's not terrible. I definitely came out liking it a bit more than what I originally did. But yeah, there you go. 7 out of 10.
Okay. Well, that leaves me. Jacob gave the very low score of 2 out of 10.
This is my Beatles for sale, Nick.
I was gonna say.
10 out of 10. I like every song on this album.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I like this much more than 4.
Oh wow.
Oh.
Yeah, this is going back to what I say, this is a 10 out of 10 album. I really enjoy this album. If you would have asked me like a month, like 4 or 5 months ago, how I feel about it, I probably would say this is probably the weakest album too. But this album is really growing on me. This album is definitely a grower. I can definitely see the turnoff though. There's like no big hits on it. This is definitely their least commercial sounding album as opposed to their other albums. So I can see where the turnoff is for most people. But you really get into it and you listen to it more, I feel like this album is more of a grower than the rest of their discography.
We will see you on our next video. Just remember that music is art and art is expression. See you later.